Welcome back. It is 6:42. Surviving one Nazi death march is amazing. Surviving two is incredible. And escaping from both is almost unbelievable. But that's what happened to Jack Hersch's father during the Holocaust.
He details it all in the book, Death March Escape. He joins us now. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So we're just, I just want to walk people through how you came to know about this story. Because your father, you said, always kind of told you in a glossed over version, oh, I escaped twice.
Right.
You know, when I was in the war, but when did you realize the depth of his story?
Well, so the actual story he liked to tell on the Jewish holiday of Passover. Passover is the holiday that commemorates the Jews escaping from Egypt some 3,000 years ago. My father liked to tell the story of his escape from the Nazis, but he told it in a very engaging and interesting, and I hate to use the word funny, but a light way. And in 2007, I get a phone call from my cousin who lives in Israel. She's my age. And she says, my dad had died in 01. She says, you're never going to believe this. Your father's on the internet. The concentration camp had his photo, a photo that I don't have, had his photo and had his story.
This is the photo.
That's exactly the photo. My father was a good-looking guy and was a model in his hometown as a kid. In that photo, he's 17 years old. He's working as a model in his hometown in Hungary. And he had the photo. He didn't give it to me after the war, but somebody had it. It turns out that the people who rescued him after the second escape had the photo. They gave it to the concentration camp. The concentration camp considered him something of a hero for having escaped. They only knew of one escape. Mm-hmm. So having escaped, they knew about this. They put it on the internet. My cousin calls me up and says, your dad's there. I do some digging and I discover that there's so much more to his story than I ever knew. And plus, they didn't know about the first escape, so I educated them, and suddenly we had a story.
Wow. So how did he escape?
So in the first escape, he was a 5'11", 160-pound guy that at the end of the war was down to 80 pounds.
Wow.
And the camp was designed as a work camp, designed really to work you to death. Mm. Towards the end of the war, they brought about 20,000 Jews into that camp as a waypoint before marching them to another camp 34 miles away. They weren't called death marches at the time, but people eventually figured out the point was for you to die on the march. Yeah. So these 20,000 were marched about 500 to 1,000 at a time, and one of the very first marches my father's put on it. He goes about 6 miles, he gets into an intersection where refugees are going north, his line of march is going west, and he suddenly realizes he's caught up with refugees. And if he just turns 90 degrees to the right, maybe nobody will notice. And he turned. And he went, and no one noticed. And he goes a couple of feet, and he finds a raincoat on the ground, and he puts it on. He goes about 100 yards and decides to knock on a door. And an old woman answers, invites him in, gives him some food, and then calls the SS.
Oh.
So then the SS come, and they decide to take him to the local police station. And the local is gendarmerie, actually. Yeah. So the local gendarme decides to let my father spend the night in the jail, and he gets him back to the camp the next day, and they don't kill him. Don't know why. Yeah. And about 10 days later, there's another forced march, another death march. And 7 miles into the march this time, he escapes again.
Wow.
And this time, a local family found him, hid him for 3 weeks until the American 65th Infantry came through. And he lived.
And they were the ones who had that picture of him. He gave that to them.
So,
yes?
this family had that photo. My father spent 18 months in a hospital after the war.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
And,
tracing the footsteps on your investigation, what was that like? Did that change you at all?
Hugely. I mean, to think that I walked in the steps of my father, where he slaved in this rock mine. There was a building called the Stone Crusher. It was the largest stone crushing machinery in Europe. And he slaved there, and I could walk on the same grounds today, or a few years ago, that my father slaved in. And then walking the death march route, and walking into the intersection where he made that decision to turn right, or about a mile past there where he bolted into trees. Mm. Walking there, my emotions ranged anywhere from anger that he had to go through this, to sadness, to, of course, in the end, joy that he pulled it off, and here I am.
It is such an amazing story. The book is called Death March Escape, the remarkable story of a man who twice escaped the Nazi Holocaust. It's available on Amazon. Jack, pleasure to meet you. Thanks for being here.
Thanks
Jack.
Me.